Hey guys, welcome back. We are going to go and continue our second day right now. Let's get back to it. Alright, so from there, we'll head out on the second day. So I need to head back to the cave and then head to the north where she stopped us last time from going. And hopefully, there'll be any more vandals. So I need to head back to that closed path. Which one's your lake? Nope, I need to find... Where's the map? I've gone the complete opposite direction. To go this way. What's the stone does? I have no idea. Right. So we go this way.
I like the outhouse in that rustic, I'm roughing it sort of way.
Yeah, it's a little privacy among the seemingly endless expanse of, well, privacy.
I like it all the same.
Yeah, I think it was through here. And down here. Yeah, okay, cool. We're going right there. So, let's continue on this way. Shit, man. How have your ankles not broken? Oh! That's just so bad on the ankles. Right. Shit, man. Just wanna head down. Jazz the breeze blows. Woodpecker. Oh my.
It's actually pretty damn cold out here.
Roger that. Warms up fast. The mornings are cold in Boulder, though, right?
Yeah, they are.
What did you get up to down there? I mean, what's life like?
I just spend a lot of time with Julia.
Oh, so you have someone there.
Well,
but you're taking a little break, or...
We're...
Look, I'm sorry. Can you hold that thought?
Sure. I'm just gonna keep hiking and hoping it warms up.
Heyo. I don't think so. Why, have you? What? Okay, good. No, I don't think he has any idea. I'm absolutely sure. Would you? All right, I'll let you know if anything changes in that regard. Hey, sorry about that. Anyway, Julia, girlfriend? Ex? Sorry, I don't mean to pry.
Who was that?
Who was who?
I don't think he has any idea. What was that? Were you talking about me?
What? What?
You left your button pressed or something.
Henry, that call was work. I was just talking to... Actually, it's not really your business. Why are you freaking out?
I'm not freaking out.
Good. I'm gonna go quiet for a little bit. Call me if it's important.
Oh, no. No. Anyway, I had no idea you'd freak out like that. Let's do a jog in. What's gonna come back to bite me at the end of the game or something? Right. Is this where I need to be?
I can see the wire you're talking about. It looks like it's in good shape from here.
We'll follow it up to the top of the trail if you can. You can head back as soon as you give me the all clear.
Got it. So we really can't reach anyone any other way than these wires?
What else do you suggest? Smoke signals?
Just seems dangerous.
Well, if they don't hear from me for a few days, they'll send someone out, but I'd rather it not come to that.
Running. Ooh, thingy box.
Guess what?
What is it?
There's a bunch of empty cans up here.
Same as before?
Yep.
These fucking kids.
Why do you think they'd be up here?
Hell if I know, but they better have stayed away from our communication stuff.
Yeah, okay, the wire's down here.
Okay, good. Any sign of those girls? Did they mess with anything?
I'll look around. Hey, so the wire is definitely down out here. I just found it. Yeah, the thing is, it doesn't look like the wind. It looks like it was cut deliberately.
I knew it. The moment you said you found their trash. These idiots are gonna pay. Do they realize this is how people die? I mean, what if something happened to one of my lookouts while this was going on? And God forbid there's an actual fire burning out of control.
What do you want to do?
I want you to go find them.
And then what?
I haven't thought that far ahead. That's not true. Everything that comes to mind is illegal.
Let's hear it.
Oh, yeah?
Hey, I came out here for a breath of fresh air and some adventure. What do you got?
I think I want you to just find them and scare the hell out of them.
Yeah, I'd make a spooky ghost costume, but they stole my sheets.
I don't know. Wait for them to wander off and wreck their camp. Something that would make a teenage girl run home to mommy and daddy.
I'll find them.
Thanks.
But I am gonna need a raise.
Don't hold your breath. I'd start by hiking back towards your tower and just keep an eye out for anything that would lead you to them.
Well, they're big into Red Eagle.
Great. See if you can find the path they took down from there. Maybe they looped back around towards the lake or something. I doubt they're where they were yesterday, but they obviously can't have gone far.
Hey, beacons. Rolling beacons. Speed on. any signs of him here. We'll see what's in there. Two, three, and there is nothing. No supplies. Okay. So I need to find the teens. I am in the wrong direction. I want to go. No, that's north. I want to go south. Cool. I want to go back this way.
There's an abandoned pack out here.
And it's not one of the teens?
No, it looks like it was lost a long time ago.
Well, you could always pilfer it for supplies.
And a shell. What you got for me? Flashed myself. And some rope.
Well, I am flush with ropes now. That pack was full of them, in decent condition, too.
That's lucky.
I mean, there's enough rope here that I could just leave them hooked up, I think. Oh, get this. This pack came with one of those cardboard single-use cameras.
With pictures left?
Yeah, he only used 3 or 4.
Neato.
Thank you, Brian Goodwin.
Wait, who?
The bag had the name Brian Goodwin sewn into the top.
Huh. Wow.
Do you know him?
Yeah, I just haven't heard that name in a few years.
What, was he a fella you had a thing with?
Yeah, it was so hot and heavy. Of course, Brian Goodwin was 12 years old, so, you know, our love could never really be understood.
Ugh.
I'm kidding. Not about him being an actual 12-year-old. That part's true. He was stationed in Two Forks, your lookout, with his dad Ned 3 summers ago. Great kid.
You can bring children out here?
No. You know, I'm not a stickler for rules. They took off halfway through the summer.
What, they couldn't handle your unique brand of charm?
Not many can.
Unsurprising.
Anyway, so it goes. Have fun with that camera. Try not to snap anything that would scar a photodome employee.
I don't know, I got a lot of hiking to do. Might get bored.
Well, I'm bored as rocks, so I'll keep you company while you find those girls, huh?
Okay, let's mark this on the map. 1, 2, 3, and 4.
Hey, who are these guys, Ron and Dave? They're leaving notes for each other in the boxes. Is there any chance one of them was that guy I saw in the canyon? You know, the guy with the flashlight?
No, they're both rangers. They're not out here this season. I didn't really know them that well, but I always assumed the only thing Ron cared about was...
Don't tell me this week.
Facing tail and getting loaded. It's somehow comforting to know that he was able to keep up a correspondence with someone who wasn't going to send him a topless Polaroid.
I guess I'll keep that.
Someone found a fossil and put it in a cash box.
Could be the same person who left that antler.
And maybe they're leaving me an entire creature, piece by piece.
Pretty cool. Oops. Okay, let's try and find these kids.
I see a really thin plume of smoke.
Yeah, I see it too. A thin plume like this is either a new fire or a campfire.
Campfire? You think it's them?
I reckon so.
It looks like it's to the southwest of me.
That's right. If you hike towards Five Mile Creek, that should put you in the neighborhood.
Hey, Delilah?
What do you got? You found him?
No, not yet. Why would there be a fence out here?
Because sometimes hikers go ass over tea kettle when on a trail.
So the Forest Service would put up a big chain link fence?
A chain link fence?
Yeah. It looks like it surrounds a huge area.
Huh. That's weird. Hey.
Who are they keeping out of here? And why?
Geez, I don't know. Maybe it's biologists, you know? Well, they don't want people traipsing on their precious lichens.
What's a lichen?
Wouldn't you lichen to know?
Oh my god, goodbye.
I'll ask next time I talk to someone, but that'll probably be a few days.
Right, let's go this way. All that way, all this way. Me thinks it's gone the wrong way. The map's there. Where am I? Right, okay, I've gone severely off trail. That way.
Hey, sorry about snapping at you earlier. I thought about it, and yeah, I suppose that must have sounded kind of weird when you heard me take that other call. Plus, you're just out here in your own head. Trust me, I know how it is. So, did you break any hearts back in Colorado when you took this job? I myself have chosen to never get attached to anyone who would miss me, but I know I'm a bit of an outlier. I don't mean that the way it sounds. I mean, I care about people, and I like companionship as much as the next person. But why does it have to come from the same person for your whole life? My Aunt Kathy was married to the same guy for 4 decades, and when he died, she found out he'd been having an affair with a real estate broker for 15 years. Whereas my Aunt Judy traveled the world dating artists and musicians as she saw fit. Call me crazy, but I'd rather spend a week in bed with Sonny Bono than half a lifetime with some cheating stockbroker.
I'm actually married.
But you're here.
Everything's fine, just, you know, we're taking some time apart, getting some fresh air.
A little change.
Yeah.
All right, well, we can just leave it at that.
Thanks.
Come on, touch the rope bit. Cool.
I'm having a hell of a time getting this fucking flapjack off his ass and out to repair that wire.
Excuse me, flapjack?
You know, like a loser, a chotch.
I really don't, but I do now.
Well, the next time you're at a bar and some banker steps on your foot so he can order his crappy martini, you've got just the name to use.
Hey, flapjack, why don't you wait your turn before I bounce your face off a dumpster?
It's beautiful!
I'm down in Thunder Canyon. I'm not seeing that smoke anymore.
Oh, it's still burning away. Try heading west from where you are. If you loop past the lake, there should be a trail that'll take you further south.
Thanks, that helps.
I'm heading in the right direction. That's red. And red. And red. Kinda missed my boombox, not a lie. Smoke on here. What's going on with the music? Where the smoke was? We're going the wrong way. Probably want to head down here as well. Okay. Let's rappel down. I don't think I can get down here without this new equipment. These are the questions we must ask. Right. Let's run.
Just so you know, I didn't mean to overstep my bounds earlier when you brought up your wife.
I know you didn't. You were just making conversation. I appreciate it.
So, tell me about her, if you want.
She's a college professor. She's a PhD in biology, evolution, and stuff.
Ooh, evolution. That's a risque subject in these parts. Man, she sounds sexy.
She sure was.
Where does she teach?
Yale.
Yale?
Yep, the Yale.
It, Henry.
She flew back and forth. I hated it.
Yeah, I would too.
Yeah. Anyway, that's her.
Okay. You're the wolf stuff. What? Missing
business. How many hikers go missing in the Shoshone?
More than none, unfortunately, with most of them being in this area. The thoroughfare, because it's so remote. Why?
I found an old flyer for a missing hiker. It just got me thinking, that's all. Like how you said one day you were talking to the Goodwins, and then the next you weren't.
Ned Goodwin didn't get mauled by a bear or stuck in a ravine. He was just a PTSD'd a-hole who dragged his son out to do a job and realized it was a bad idea.
PTSD? That doesn't sound good.
I don't know. He was in the army. He was off. It's actually the saddest story. He was only discharged because his mother, Brian's grandmother, died. She'd been taking care of him, and Ned was the only next of kin.
Damn. And you got to know Brian a little bit?
Yeah. I talked to him way more than I'd talked to Ned, that's for sure.
How was he at, spotting fires?
Better than you. He actually liked to stay in the tower.
Boy, for as dry as it is this summer, there's an area down here that's, lush.
Oh, you must be talking about the Aspen Grove down there.
Yeah, I think that's where I am.
Those trees are actually one root organism. Did you know that?
I didn't.
Yeah, they share their water as a colony that can live for hundreds of years, even through fire. Can you believe you're actually getting paid to learn all of these amazing things? Also, by what it looks like on this map, you'll be coming up on a stream that should lead you towards where we saw that smoke.
Stream. Look, here's a stream. Let's keep going this way. I'm gonna find my way back.
Hey, what's to the south of here?
Mexico? Is this some sort of riddle?
I just have a nice view to the south. You know, trees and mountains forever.
Eventually, you'll wander into the area overseen by Chimney Rock Lookout, but that's probably an impossible hike in terms of terrain.
You're doing it again.
There's some cloth out here. It looks like it was torn from something.
Strange.
I'll keep looking around.
Man, what is going on?
It's a really nice waterfall down here. Given those girls love a skinny dipping, I bet they're nearby.
Going the right way.
Well, I found the source of that fabric. Their tent looks like it's been through the shredder.
You're there? Where are they?
I don't know. Gone. This whole place is torn apart.
What happened?
I have no idea. It's pretty bad.
Well, just look around. Make sure they weren't, you know, injured or...
Murdered?
They weren't murdered.
Do you remember when I came out here to quietly look for fires?
They weren't. Just look around. Actually, you've got that camera, right? It might be a good idea to get a few snaps, just in case.
Yeah, good thinking. Looks like someone left a note.
Intriguing. Maybe you should read it.
Okay, yeah.
Let me know what it says.
Oh, they're gone, for sure.
Well, what's it say?
To call the police because they think I attacked them.
Oh my god, well, did you?
No, well, hey, I didn't do this, okay? Someone or something went to town here, but it wasn't me.
Because I told you to scare them, not assault them.
Yeah, I took their whiskey back at the lake, but that just felt like, I don't know, the cost of doing business.
That's different, okay? And I don't blame you.
This is, I don't know, weird as hell, but it wasn't me.
It's okay. I believe you. Weird stuff happens in the woods. It could be other campers. They could be having a bad mushroom trip. We really don't know, but they're gone. There's no way to call the cops. They're not coming back, and we can get to work. I'd really like to start enjoying a quiet summer.
Yeah, me too.
Well, no, what did it... Well. Okay. Seeing as day two ended, we will end this session here. So, thank you very much for watching. This is starting to heat up, so I really want to know what's happening.
What do you look like?
Why are you asking?
Because I'm horribly superficial.
Well, I get confused for Burt Reynolds all the time.
Oh, is that so?
Women say that we have a similar musk. Hey, you asked.
Okay, well, that gives me a good start. Now let's see. In my scope, I can only tell you're a white guy wearing shorts.
It's hot. And maybe, by the way, I'm not white. It's not very, you know, PC or whatever they say.
Oh my god, you are the whitest man. Wow. I don't need a spotting scope for that. And if not shorts, then what do you normally like to wear?
Tuxedos, as often as possible.
Oh, really?
You bet.
How cosmopolitan. I didn't realize Boulder was so chic.
It is the peak of high society.
Good to know, dear, yes. Now tell me about your face. I'm looking at you across the bar. What do I see?
End it off for this.
Pretty thick beard.
Oh, have you always had a beard?
For a while, yeah.
Alright, perfect. I want to know about your eyes.
Get out of here.
I'm drawing you. I need to know.
Your what?
Is that okay? Don't answer. I'm gonna do it regardless.
Fine.
Your eyes, tell me.
Steely.
They're steely. A cold, hard stare.
Like a Siberian husky.
Sure.
Okay, got it. Thank you, Henry.
You get what you need?
Absolutely.
All these pieces of wood. Let's get more. Oh. There's another one. Oh. Okay. That's what that's for. There's a wooden board. Right. Almost there. Fix the window, then we'll pull it quits. Right, let's board up this window. Damn. This guy's efficient.
I got that window all patched up. So, what should I do now? What's next?
What's next? What do you think is next?
Well, you've been the one giving me tasks for 2 days straight.
What's next is you sit in that room until September 1st and call me at the first sign of smoke.
Oh, yeah.
Why don't you let me know when you're mentally prepared for that task and, I'll give it to you.
Okay, I think I am ready to tackle my long-term commitment of keeping this national forest safe from total destruction.
I am glad to hear you've really thought this through.
You know, I'm gonna hike around for a while before I really put my nose to the grindstone.
Oh, yeah, you do that.
Okay, now I'm ready. Let's get to work.
How are those precious few seconds of jobless freedom?
Oh, magical.
Good. Now get to work.
What? Was this a sudden jump?
Hello, Henry. Having a nice afternoon?
I might never leave.
Well, I come up with some bad news. Two young women, Chelsea Stevens and Lily McLean, were reported missing. They've got parents out in California who haven't heard from them in a week. They were supposed to meet an aunt down in Cody. If they're the girls from last week, then you're probably the last person to have seen them.
You should tell whoever that I'm happy to be questioned.
Look, it's not gonna be an issue. I mean, if they turn up dead, then maybe.
This took a very moment.
Should I just not say anything and save us the trouble?
I think it's worth mentioning something.
Yeah. I'll keep it vague. I really don't want to talk to the cops.
Me neither.
All right, Henry, thanks. Enjoy the sunset.
What? Okay,
Henry.
Then.
Henry, wake up.
Okay, off to whatever this is.
Get out of bed and pick up the radio.
I'm gonna stop playing.
What do you want?
Hey, you big dumb idiot.
Hi, Jules.
Oh, you sound tired.
I am.
Are you having a nice time?
Yeah, it's good here. It's beautiful, you know?
That's great, Henry. Really great. Well, I'll let you get back to sleep then.
Okay, Jules.
Delilah seems nice.
Sure.
Bye, baby.
What? Man, these sudden days. Okay. We are stopping here.
Is it too much of a pain in the ass to bring supplies all the way up to our towers?
Well, I get my stuff hand-delivered.
Oh, how's that work?
It's the perks of a decade of service. You're out hiking in 90-degree heat, and I get to do crosswords. Isn't life miserably unfair? Anyway, when you find the supply drop, remember it's not just for you, okay? Other lookouts, biologists, a few people get their food there, and I don't want to have to call in for more. There should be loads of good stuff, though. Beans, prunes, jerky. You know, my sister eats 6 prunes a day. 6. She's, like, really precise about it. She'd be great at this job if she didn't need wheelbarrows full of marijuana to function.
Okay. We're done. thank you very much for watching.
So 2 weeks ago, you called me in the middle of the night. You were sleeping, I guess, and all I heard was the name Jules through the mumbles. I just thought it was so sweet. I wanted to wake you up, but then I thought maybe you were having a nice conversation and I'd just be spoiling it. Is there anything else you want to tell me about her?
Yeah, actually. Look, I wasn't honest with you about her.
Well, why not?
Because I messed up. She got really early Alzheimer's and I lost her. She's still alive. She's being taken care of back in Australia, because that's where she's from. She's there.
Oh my God, Henry.
And that's it.
I'm so sorry.
Yeah.
Henry, listen. My God, I'm so sorry you've gone through that. I don't know if you've thought of it this way, but her family is taking care of her, and you need to take care of you.
Thanks.
I'll let you keep hiking.
Okay, no more. We're done. Good. Thanks for everything. Goodbye.